When I was a child, my father tried to scare me into adhering to a curfew with an urban legend. It was about an ageless man who lived in the village and practiced black magic. He was able to open doors into dark dimensions and commune with demons and long-dead spirits. Mystic, my father called him. As I grew older, my father's boogeyman lost its impact. I told myself that such a person didn't exist outside my old man's imagination. I've long since eaten those words because I'm watching my father's boogeyman at work. I've sought his help in finding out exactly what forces are after an infant that was left in my care, and why. And as scared as my father's vision of the boogeyman made me as a kid, dealing with the real thing as I have for the last hour is infinitely more unsettling.
I sense nothing.
When he speaks, the hairs on the back of my neck stand up. I had to compose myself enough to ask, "Are you sure?" The man who gave it to me claimed to be an organization called Sheol. He knew things about me that aren't a matter of record.
I assure you, Devil, the Eye of Agamotto would have revealed any supernatural elements that this trinket might have been exposed to. As it stands, the cross indicates no mystical influence whatsoever. Of it, I can tell you only that its manufacture was recent, and also that it is a porous metal, which would stand to reason as it was clearly designed to transfer the drug.
The drug? What drug?
Well, surely you knew. It is laced with a chemical of some sort. A synthetic toxin, I believe. I absorbed a trace of it into my bloodstream and it registered mildly as an hallucinogen. I'd imagine that even the small trace I've been exposed to was enough to make one highly susceptible to suggestion.
But if it did carry a drug, then why didn't it affect you?
It would have. I felt starting to. But I was able to cast a small spell that purged it out of my system and into an alternate dimension within my cell structure.
Long story. Don't ask.
The toxin is void of color and taste. Doesn't appear to have a scent either. To be quite honest, if it weren't for the eye, I doubt I would have picked up on it at all. Until it was well into my bloodstream.
I've been drugged.
So it would appear. And further, my brief investigation on the astral plane revealed no stirrings in regards to a savory child of any faith or practice. Especially not the Christian Redeemer. I should, in all fairness, add that my mystic abilities as of late have been rather undependable.
It can't be. He's wrong. He's in on it.
Perhaps if you were to bring the child here, I can be of more assistance.
Humanity's destroyer. I should have known that to trust a practitioner of the black arts, especially one who's, no doubt, exerting suggestive spells to cloud my thinking. Well, allow me to return the favor. Physically.
The toxin is again active in your system. I'm removing it with the same incantation I used on myself. There. It is gone.
My God.
How do you feel?
I feel clear. Thanks, Doc.
Is everything all right, boss?
No need for alarm, Wong. Our friend Daredevil wishes infected with a rather unsavory time-released toxin.
Time-released?
Yes. Or rather, associative response. The toxin had attached itself to the synapses of your cerebral cortex. It seemed to activate upon suggestion of the child's innocence, and clouded your ability to reason logically.
Natasha, I have to find you. Explain my actions. I'm so sorry.
Quite a drug, that one. The criminal element could probably mass produce it for consumption in social circles that seek to lower inhibitions.
Your rave clubs, your college frats.
Strange. I need to know who's behind all this. Is there any way we can find out beyond your inquiry on the astral plane?
Well, there is another way, though it'll require a strong connection and your complete obedience in observing the guidelines I lay out. If you're willing to give it an attempt.
I'm willing to try anything at this point.
Very well. It'll take a day to prepare you. We'll start immediately. Wong, would you be so kind as to move the tea into the cellar? I'm going to invoke a demon.
Business as usual at Cassette's range. Follow me, Red.
So this is your life, Karen Page. In your 30-plus years, you've been your parents' daughter, your grade school's bright young speller, your high school's straight-A student and cheerleading captain, your college 3.8 GPA graduate, a secretary for a small but earnest law firm, a would-be actress, a one-time porn star, a former junkie, a recovering addict, a radio DJ so popular you've broadcasted from Botkos, and now an HIV carrier. And what of the men in your life? There have been a number of them, haven't there? And you've been so many things to all of them. A daughter, a friend, a lover, an object of desire, a customer, a voice in the night. And then there's that one guy, the one to whom you've been all and more. The one you prized more than anything in your life, and then betrayed, and then found salvation in, and then abandoned, and then sought out when your world shattered, and then tried to deceive, to save your own skin. It's always been you, Matt. You're the pivot point that has given my adult life balance. No matter what I've done or where I've gone, I always come back to you. In my haste to unload my problems on you, I never thought to ask what was going on in your life, your lives, even after what the old man told me. It's something I've always taken for granted. You practice law by day, you practice justice by night, and always made it seem effortless. But it's always been bigger than you, hasn't it, love? You've been able to stay one step ahead of madness, or the grave through it all. But how can one step ever be enough? And where's the margin for error? That's always been the unspoken fear, hasn't it, Matt? The thing that plagued you in your sleep, when I held you on the rare nights you were home. That one day you'll stumble, and whatever darkness laps at your heels will swallow you whole. Is this that time, love? Is the darkness bearing down closer than it ever has? And are you running out of strength to stay ahead of it? You need me, Matt. Now, more than ever, you need my strength to ally with your own. And maybe then we can both outrace the void. And in order to give you my strength, I have to muster it, not collapse into your arms, hoping you'll fix it all again. I've spent most of my life, our life, doing that, haven't I? Perhaps this is the time that instead of collapsing, either of us, we should be leaning one another, as equals. A partnership, one that, for the first time in years, can be built on level ground. Two broken souls that, together, can be whole. I need you now, yes. More than ever. But you need me. Just as much.
The Sanctum Sanctorum of Stephen Strange. The good doctor offered me nose plugs. It seemed that when a doorway to hell is opened, the stench can be so overwhelming that it's been known to asphyxiate those within close proximity. Apparently, the basement deaths of at least 8 to 10 amateur magicians per year that are chalked up to radon gas are misreported. I've been instructed not to address the visitor when it shows up. Stephen told me that even one verbal misstep in a conversation with a demon could result in freeing it from whatever binding circle that it keeps it in check. Stephen said he'd summoned a demon with a dead tongue. A tongue recorded only in one 8,000-year-old manuscript he keeps locked in a vault of a Swiss bank under an assumed name. He said it's best to avoid eye contact with the beast, as you want to do as little as possible to provoke the demon. Strange said a lot of things. He neglected to mention who he was summoning.
Who calls me to this dismal place?
I don't need eyes to know who is standing before me.
Who dares to summon Mephisto?
He doesn't remember me.
You've encountered Mephisto before.
I know this thing, yes.
Then you know how dangerous he is. I've encoded an obstruction into the binding circle. He'll be unable to see us, though I don't know for how long.
Primitive. What manner of fool is responsible for this clownish prison?
You are called here by a magus of the highest order for an inquisition.
Strange. I recognize your brain. We have danced as this before, but never with blinders. What prompts this secrecy now?
Within the binding circle, you may ask of me no questions, and provide only answers, beast.
Ah, you're playing the role with all the stops pulled out, aren't you, Mystic? This isn't a conversation, it's a performance.
Do not respond. Do not speak.
You've brought a friend, I gather. But you're so terse with your unseen guest, good doctor. What is it that disturbs you, Stephen?
Mephisto laughs quietly and rattles strange nerves. I hear his pulse rise and then calm again as he regains his composure and says,
Beast, there are those who purport that Christian Redeemer has returned to this plane as an infant. I command you who stands within the confines of this binding circle to tell me if there is any validity to their claims. And think twice before you offer a lie, lest I close this window and return you to perdition.
You say that as if it's a threat. But I'll play your vocal game's game, Strange, if for no other reason than it amuses me to do so at this time. So your companion wants to know if John's foretold apocalypse is nigh, eh? If I had a soul for every time I'm asked that question.
Answer the query, Pit Dweller, or this conference is at an end.
Why is one so mighty as myself brought here to instruct as a Sunday school teacher? Have your Christian friend read his Bible, more specifically, the Apostle John's Book of Revelations. When the so-called Son of God returns, presumably to end his father's floundering exercise, the blunder known as mankind, it won't be as he came originally. In a rare fit of good sense, he's prophesied to return not born of a lowly woman, but as judge, jury, and executioner, as a lion, not a lamb. As that which will end your world and deliver the pure to his father and the rest of us. Now, I'm no literary major, but I'd say that text is indicating a far different manifestation the so-called Redeemer than as a human infant, wouldn't you, my inquisitive friend of Strange?
My God. He's right. Biblically, the Savior is to come back as he left. A man.
Prove to me your omniscience, Mephisto, and reveal who it is that sows these untruths.
Why, Stephen? Has someone tricked your friend into believing the infant Savior's been left in his care? Can your friend really have been so blind?
He knows. He knows who I am.
I'm closing the portal.
Hello again, blasphemer. He would call himself a devil and would do the work of the just. With that, I could cross the threshold of the binding circle. I would take more than your vision. But that is a pleasure one of your fellow meatlings has beaten me to. Oh yes.
Who?
Devil, no! The portal is almost closed.
Who is doing this to me? What more have they taken?
Good things come to those who wait, Vigilante. No, I will tell you this. I'm reserving a choice seat in the pit for the one who's making of your life a hell on Earth. He's more than earned it. Who would have thought it possible of a third rear? Not me. Not his peers. Probably not even his own mother. How delicious this must be. The broken heart of the harlot that sired your nemesis. How she must have harbored such high hopes for a child who festered into a liar, a thief, a murderer of men, and a killer of children. The disgrace must have her spinning in her grave.
Almost there?
But sooner or later, it happens to even the best children, doesn't it, Blasphemer? Sooner or later, every son lets his mother down.
No. The Clinton mission shelter. I have to choke back the bile that's rising in my throat. The room reeks with the stench of silent terror and death. There are moments when I'm almost glad I can't see. This is one of them.
Devil.
Maggie! Don't move.
He killed Sister Teresa first. With her own rosary beads. He said... he said he'd kill us. One by one. If we didn't give him the baby. But I... hid her. The things he did. To Sister Anne.
I know when he left, Maggie. When did he leave?
If a body meet a body,
he
coming
didn't.
Through the rye. Rye. Ain't it red? If you're the literary type, you'll be able to call this one devil.
I can't get beat on him. The acoustics in the church are throwing echoes back at me.
No? Come on. It's too easy.
It sounds like it's coming from... there.
You're the catcher. Get it? You're the catcher in the rye. But you know what every good catcher needs? A pitcher!
Three are distractions for the fourth. This one was meant for my jugular. Great son of a... Anything's a weapon in his hands. The teeth were meant for my eyes.
Same old Red. That's why I came prepared this time. I'm tired of this vendetta between you and me. It's a waste of my time. You're the only guy who's ever come close to getting on my nerves. Hate admitting it, but you're almost my better. So in an effort to afford myself a shot, I'm going to subvert my principles a bit. Now we're even.
The pain. Worse than when Natasha shot me. Drown it out, Murdoch. Have to keep Bullseye at bay.
You little...
Rumor has it, his skeleton is reinforced with adamantium. That blow confirms it.
You want to walk away from this? You'll give me the kid. I ain't getting paid to kill you. But I'm gonna do you for free, just for laughs.
Go to hell.
I already wrote that ticket. With all the dead nuns.
Sister?
Karen.
We gotta get you out of here.
No, child. You must go. Get help. He'll kill Matthew. If he doesn't get the child.
Sister, where's the baby?
I'm not going to beat him.
Tell me where the kid is, and I'll do you quick.
Mother, I'm sorry. Mother.
Give me the kid!
Let him go. Let him go, and I'll give you the baby.
Well, well, well. Big hand for the little lady.
Karen, no!
Pipe down, Punchy. We're in the middle of negotiations. Even, miss. Now, let me get this straight. You want to trade the newer model for the old meter.
If you let him live, the baby is yours. If we have a deal, step away from Daredevil.
What can I say? I'm a sucker for the ladies. Another time then, Red. How about when we're done here, you'll let me show you what a great shot I am.
Just take the baby and get out.
Karen, you can't.
This is easier than taking candy from a... You gotta be kidding me, lady! How could you double-cross me like that? In a church, no less! Where the hell is that baby? Well, what do you know? Out of the mouth of babes, as they say.
Don't!
A page from the Gospel according to Bullseye, sister. No one rises from the dead!
Stop! Put the baby down.
Man, you're a persistent broad. First rule in cleaning business. Never discard a loaded weapon. I only brought one bullet, lady. How'd you think I got the name? You got chutzpah, kid. And for that, I'm gonna let you live. Right now. Wait a second. Where are my manners? I almost left without giving Red back his... club!
Matt!
I can't believe it. I missed.
Oh my god. Please god, no. I hear the blood forcing itself out of a hole in her chest.
Matt.
No, baby, don't try to talk. Just... okay.
I... love...
I try not to hear her. Hearing her means knowing. Karen.
Miss you.
And with that, she's gone.